Hello, welcome back to my channel. I am Erica. This is my video on how to be creative during lockdown. Being in the same place all the time is not really conducive to being creative. Creativity requires inspiration, novelty, fresh air, for there not to be a deadly pandemic. So I decided to outline a few things that I do to be and stay creative during lockdown, even when I really don't feel like it. Number one, feed your foundation. What's your main talent? Are you a musician? Practice. Are you a designer? Draw. Are you an accountant? Do math? Honing your best skills allows you to more easily flourish in adjacent directions. And by doing this, you are reminding yourself of those skills, which adds to your general feeling of self-worth. General feeling of self-worth? It's good to have long-term goals, absolutely, but make sure you have a solid foundation from which to grow. Number two, try something new. Now, before you switch off, I'm not saying you need to take up ballet or knitting or, God forbid, running. I'm saying watch a new film. Read a new book, read a new article, listen to that new album by what's her name. You know the one. You haven't gotten around to it yet. Now is the time. This is a good way of adding variety to your day of staring at the same four walls. Admittedly, I don't always want to watch or listen to new things because sometimes it takes a lot of energy for me to engage. But I know from experience that when I do, it gives me some much needed inspiration. Number three, write a journal. This is an excellent way of sifting through your thoughts to find nuggets of inspiration. I forced myself to do this nearly every day for the first few months of the pandemic, and on the days when I did not feel like doing it are honestly the days when I wrote the best stuff. There are songs that exist in this world because I made myself write a poem one day. The other day I was writing in my journal, very melodramatically, about how my life is not very fulfilling right now. So I wrote a poem about an empty glass. Doesn't sound very exciting, but it was creative as fuck. Number four, go outside. Just do it. If you're able to leave the house, for the love of God, go outside and move. Nature is inspiring. People are inspiring. Buildings are inspiring. So go outside and look at them. And if you can't go outside, look outside. Drink your coffee by the window. Do some people watching. Do some bird watching. But look. And looking is not active, by the way. Looking is passive. It means allowing whatever it is you're seeing to influence you. If you're visually impaired, may I suggest listening to people talking, listening to birds, touching flowers or trees as you pass, but take something else in besides your own thoughts. Number five, do boring things. This one took me a while to figure out, and it is important for any overachievers out there. Creative tasks or work stuff takes a lot of brain power and energy. So make sure you are doing boring, easy tasks alongside your creative ones. Doing the dishes, although dull, and maybe the amount of them makes you want to scream sometimes, maybe, actually gives you a well-needed break from working. You're using your body, you get to touch warm water, you're doing what our ancestors have been doing for millennia, and bonus, then your dishes are done. Life hack. While doing boring tasks like laundry or taking out the trash or cleaning the toilet, your brain has the time to digest what it's just made and avoid getting, as I like to say, too close to the project. It also renews your creative energy and might actually get you to see the thing you're working on from a different perspective. That's it. Those are my five tricks for how to be creative during lockdown. But I would like to add, if you are feeling pressure to be creative right now, maybe because you're seeing other people being super creative and it's making you feel like crap, remember that everyone is different. And more importantly, everyone is coping differently. And we are all coping. My way of coping is to make things sort of constantly. If I'm not making things, then I think about stuff I don't want to think about. But that does not work for everyone, nor should it. Take the time that you need to make the stuff you like to make. And give yourself a break. But also, if these tricks did work for you, please let me know. Give me feedback in the comment section. Maybe only one of these tricks worked for you. Maybe you tried something completely different. Let's help each other out so that we can make more art. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already and hit the notification bell so you don't miss my next video on how to be productive during lockdown. And, you know, share the video with your nearest and dearest who might need a little bit of a creative boost.